Van has had a lot of changes. The electrical is going great. So now the batteries are installed, boxed up, they're safe back there. I got some new solar panels, and that's the next step. Install these new solar panels. ProMaster Roof has a well-designed system where you don't have to drill through the roof. It's this little thing that sticks up that kind of has a thing like that on top. So you slide something there, put something there, you screw it in. That's what we've been using for years now to hold our solar. We've got a cheap roof rack. The rails have been fine, but the uprights that went to the rails, those are long gone. Drilled out of a steel bar, these new uprights, super strong, haven't had any issue with them. Getting up there in the cold and unbolting these things, probably the hardest step.
I measured about the new solar panels, and they are gonna fit front to back behind that fan. Before the back here, 57 inches, it's tight, but a couple inches to spare on either side. So yeah, let's get this surfboard off here, get these guys down. So I got all the four uprights loosened except for this one here. This one is such a long bolt that I can't get the ratchet in there. And then we can just take the thing off. Just lifts right out there. Oh, almost forgot to disconnect. Gotta get underneath here. This is the inlet that goes down to my system. Positive and a negative. This is just a quick disconnect here. All right, look how bare that roof looks. Looks good. Getting that thing down, not too bad. Here it is. I remember now when I mounted these solar panels, the gap here is so tight that it's hard to get in there. Oh, whoa, that, oh my gosh, look at this. Down in here, there's a bolt right there. I have to go right here. So you're blocked there, here. To get in there, you can't get the socket wrench in there. That'd be like the easy way. Click, 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 you're done. No, it's gonna be half turn, actually, a quarter turn because it's blocked here and here. Oh God. Good thing you don't have to do this often. Get a million quarter turns to get this one on the end loosened. Maybe I can just slide out and see what happens. Oh, heck yeah. Got one of those off just by sliding it out. Solar panels always have these mounting holes they come with, but it wasn't in the exact right spot. Drilled a hole here, put this bolt through, which is sort of just how this roof rack works. This is like a cheaper one off of Amazon. Can't remember the name. Don't quite suggest it because we did have to replace this. Having aluminum, this piece of aluminum kept breaking. This has been fine. It's been a good system. I did have enough extra hardware that I'm not going to have to mess about anymore with these old panels to get out those things. These are the guys designed to fit in our roof rack, then a washer, then these nylon locking nuts. Wow, so there you can see the sheer size difference. This is a 220 watt panel. That was a hundo. I think I'll mount this one before I take that one off to make sure the rails stay the same difference. So now I gotta drill a hole in the new solar panel. Got the first hole drilled, the first two. All right, the moment of truth. Getting the new panel slid onto here. I think I got a good idea here. I got this flat, I can put it here. Too far?
Yeah.
Oh no, I drilled those holes. They're a little bit too close together. This guy isn't going in here. I mean, the way that that hardware works, if it's more of like a channel than a hole, the washer and everything is gonna be fine, hopefully. So that's the old hole, this is the new one. I'm trying to level up my technique. I think if I put tape, maybe it'll make it easier to keep the drill bit there. Oh, finally got it. I switched technique. Now got it set up like this, so it's really easy to test. Not super happy with it. Kind of drilled two holes next to each other, so it's like a channel. But I'll get better for each time, I'm sure. Hopefully I can slide this on running out of daylight. So these actually slide pretty good once you get them loose. I just loosened up this one, keeping it on there until I get this one fully on. Wow, that's tricky. Now I can get the next one in here. I was talking to my buddy who works in the aerospace industry, and he told me about a thing called match drilling. I've measured that's the same distance as that one, and now I've just clamped it right where it goes. I'm gonna use that hole. It doesn't go all the way through, so I gotta drill through two things. Drill straight down exactly where the hole's gonna be. Putting this wood here. That drilled a perfect hole. Got those guys on there. I'm still pretty nervous about when I put it on the roof. Is everything gonna be good? So even though it's nighttime, hopefully Emily can help me put these up there. I've just clamped things together so that nothing slides as we're putting it up on the roof. We've never done this at night, so it'll be fun. Yes! got the panels up on the roof. Just got to tighten them up. So now we have in the middle, nice little area that we can walk down and clean off the solar panels when they're dirty or got snow on them. Nothing left to do now except for tighten up a million things. Connect the electrical. Look at these guys. All tightened up, hooked up. Finally got a nice sunny day. Looks like the panels are producing pretty well. Check out the stats here. What I'm doing right now is the Webasto, the new controller for the Webasto heater. So there you can see the cable going up, and there's already these cables here for like the seat. I tried to get it really good up on the side this time. You can see from this angle. It goes down under here, over here to the bats. And then it goes up here where I'm at the controller. There's the Webasto. We got the cables running over here for the battery area, sort of collected. They envision is that you're gonna run this right to a battery terminal, so they put these guys on here. What I'm gonna do, these are the old cables, just shove them down in there. I'll leave them until I know that the new one's gonna be bulletproof. I'm gonna use these Wagos to connect to this cable they got here. That way, instead of running the heater off of our starter battery, it's gonna go off of our electrical system in the back there. But yeah, I already ran this up for the last controller. And so we'll pop it in here in this end, and you can see from the bottom, it's all the way in. Clamp that boy, try it, don't come out. We'll clamp it down, that'll do. One nice looking connection there. All right, so this is the point where it gets a bit tricky. You can see I got the dash panel opened here. So I'm gonna remove this and try to get the new one in there. So there, you know, those went to the Webasto. One goes out to connect to the battery, and the other is gonna come under here, up here, matching the old cable. We'll go into the controller. I can mount this to a piece of wood to get that extra width I need. Kind of a Frankenstein contraption. Not bad. And you never even really have to touch it with the Bluetooth. Time to finish up this electrical work. So, you know, the batteries have been running great. Now we want some AC power. Gotta wire this guy up. These are the biggest cables in the van, 2-aught. And the fuse holder broke. Get these. Oh boy, what was that? Looks like it popped off. So I got a new fuse holder. Create the cable from the positive to there. From there to the positive of this. Create the cable negative from the shunt to there. And then there's another that connects this to ground to the bus bar in the front. And we'll have AC power again. I did put the remote switch. I'm going to put that in the new charging area we have. I'm making this nice, really nice panel out of wood. I drilled the holes for it. And we're going to have 3 USB and USB-C outlets, fast charge. And then there's a DC outlet, which we have for a few things. And then below it, there's the inverter remote switch and the AC outlets. I'll wire that up to here after, once I get that in. Time to wire up this inverter. And here's the new fuse block, 150 amp. And that's gonna go right here before the inverter. Last time I had it a little too close to here, it was hard to get in there. But yeah, if it doesn't work, I'll just move it. By the way, this thing is so hard to get off once you put it on. We'll start with that short little cable there. 5/16 or M8, and that fits perfect there. It's time to use this guy again to hammer crimp it. And I learned about this since last time. You wanna put it in there, get it ready, and tap it, and it'll sound like hollow. And when you first hear kind of like a solid sound, like when it changes noise, then the crimp is done. So let's try that this time, see how it goes. All right, now we got a short little cable fuse, so let's wire this up. All right, so I did check the manual, and the order they recommend to connect the cables is first ground the chassis, next do the positives, and then do the negatives to the battery. So I'm just gonna reuse this. It's kind of a small cable, probably not connect to the other end. So now I gotta figure out how to get the negative and the positive down to the battery here. The shunt is where the negative connects. So I'm thinking I'll make a little hole here. Run those down here. It looks like I'll be able to reuse this cable. Ends like right at the right spot, really. Now to make the one last cable, which will go from here to there. All right, it's the big moment to wire up the inverter. All the cables are ready. Anytime you're working on an electrical circuit, you always want to shut off the electricity. Lights out. So if that's washers aren't enough, I'll just throw one of these on it, I guess. Make up some extra room and get a washer later. Adding the inverter to the mix here. That is a crowded party right there. If you tighten this wrong, you could mess up your whole battery. Okay, that's gotta be it.
All right, well, I'm pretty happy how that turned out. Had to sand off a little bit of this corner so that would still fit on, but that's a nice straight shot down to the bats. Now for the negative. But before I do that, I am gonna electrical tape around there. You wouldn't want those two to touch. I don't know why they don't have a nice cover for that, but I'll just electrical tape it. Now it's time for the main event, connecting the last attachment here.
Hey, no spark, just a little teeny noise. Now I'll put on that lock washer.
All right, those connections are looking solid. So over here is the on button. Hey, we got AC power. That's what this does. It converts from 12 volt batteries to normal household power. Seeing the trunk put back together like that with the minor changes we've made makes me so happy. But yeah, it just feels like such a relief. The batteries are in, the solar's installed, the inverter's installed again, and I just feel like I can finally relax. So in the electrical stuff here, you see this is gonna be our charging area. I'm making that charger, all those chargers that are gonna go up in the corner. This thing looking sweet, right? That'll go up in the top corner there, and the cables will run down. Now the issue is we're out of fuse box spots. Yeah, I installed a new spot to put a new fuse box here. Let me show you. So you see there's the old fuse box completely full up, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a new fuse box here. Then these cables will just really clean go right to it. Before picture. And the max that that breaker or that fuse box can handle is 100 amps. So I checked with the Blue Sea Systems wiring guide and they say 6 AWG is good for a foot long run that can support 100 amps. Here's the first cable that connects the fuse box. You can actually use that hammer crimper, even though this is only 6 AWG. To connect the positive, I'm going to shut off the lights, shut off the breaker. So normally, yeah, this would be shutting off the lights. Oh my God, what it was I forgot to shut off the solar panels. That's bad. Apparently, if you still have juice flowing into here and it's not going to batteries, it can burn this thing out. So I just flipped the switch, but I should have done that first. Oops. All right, so I got the positive to the breaker, the negative to the negative bus bar, and now I can turn back on the lights. Okay, can turn back on the solar now. Always disconnect your solar before you disconnect it from the batteries.
There it is, vacuumed in with the covers on the fuse boxes. But that fuse box is ready to send power up to the new charging station here.
So now it's time to figure out the wires for this guy. Really excited to wire this up. Gonna be up in that corner there. Figure out how long I want the cables. I got one started here, duct taped here so it won't move. Ran it back here, and let's go in the trunk and see how I'm gonna get it to there.
What would be best, I mean, what would be easiest is drill a hole right here, but that's a little ways from the wall. So if I do that, is that long enough? I think so.
So I'm gonna protect the wiring with this conduit here. It'll be tight, but it'll be good.
See, I'll have that up there. Run it down, straight down there. So I'll run it down here.
Can do more ugly stuff underneath, but here, that'd be a nice straight run. So I just have to drill a hole there, drill a hole there.
It was impossible to drill that hole there with this shelf in, so I took the shelf out, I'll cut the hole in that. Whoa, I think we're through.
All right, let's see what we got from this side again.
Oh, that's perfect. This is looking good. So this would come up here.
It's gonna have to be a little bit longer, it looks like.
Okay, so this is plenty long.
Figured out the solution to getting all these cables ran. I looked up the numbers here for this cable. This can handle 45 amps for the distance I'm going at 12 volts. I could run all of these off of one cable, but I think what I'm gonna do is run these off of one cable and these off of one cable. So they'll be in parallel at the end. And they came with these little fuse holders so I could fuse them individually and on the other end fuse them cumulatively. You know, this is like telephone wire, telephone jack thing. So that's actually smaller than the other cable. We're basically testing we can get all these cables. One each for those DC appliances. We'll have the AC cable, and then we'll have, you know, this. So biggest one first, the one that has the thing on the end.
Two of these, that AC, kind of snug, but they have a lot of room. I need to get that conduit in the piece of wood. So glad I'm done getting those cables to here. Now I can do something fun, get this all wired up, charge my phone or something with it. I'm excited.
That
that's basically how it's gonna work.
I'm gonna have to trim it. So I put some tape there. I got the conduit trimmed to length. When you have one cable that goes to two things, it's nice to separately fuse them. These outlets actually did come with a fuse holder on the wire there. On the positive side, they have that fuse holder. So what I've decided to do with this cable is cut it up a bit, basically make these pieces. So here I crimped on a quick disconnect, nice short cable with that fuse there for the positive side. On the negative side, I cut it near the thing I want to use. Say you have one cable in, positive goes to two positives. So that's a three branch connection. So I'm going to use these Wago connectors here. I'll put in the negative is coming into the box for these two outlets. Out will go that piece that I was able to reuse to each outlet on the negative. On the positive side, I'll have the positive of the cable that's for two outlets. On the two positive sides that go to the outlets, I will be using that inline fuse holder it came with. I can reuse a lot of the cable and wire this up. So now I just gotta connect it to that. This is a pretty cool outlet because it's just like those Wago connectors. You flip open a switch, put a wire in there, and then that's all you gotta do. The control center here, I got all the clip-ins ready to clip in. Time to install that. I was able to get that conduit in there, strip back these wires. I think I'm gonna leave them long. I can just lean in here and connect this up pretty easy. Wow, almost there, I'm stoked. Everything's stripped back. Got those ones through the box there. These ones ready for their Wagos. I think I will electrical tape the ground. That's looking good. Of course, the other side is not wired up. Here's the simplest connection here. So actually at this point, I'm realizing I better do the other end because these cables here, they're not plugged in and they're not red or black. So I'll wire it up right now. I'll know this end, which is positive, which is negative. Using trusty multimeter for 12 volt or 24 volt, you would put it on this 20 symbol. Touch the red and the black to each side of the wire, and if you have red and black correct, you'll have a positive number there. If not, you'll see a negative number. So the first thing we should make sure of is that these wires are not going to touch. 30 amp fuse here for two 10 amp outlets. Pop that in there. So one of these should be live here. I want to see what this says. It says negative 13. So we know I have it backwards. I'll flip these two. Now you can see we're showing a positive voltage. So that means this one over on the left is the negative. Just have to connect these things. There's no fuse connected, of course, so these aren't live right now. But we'll make sure we got that fully in the Wago connector. Very solid, very solid. Pretty much everything should be working. Let's put a couple of fuses in there. We'll test it out. I can see already these guys have lit up. Look at this panel. So here you can already see these three outlets are on. You can shut them all off, which is one thing I love about these. The top you see it's a 65 watt fast charger as well. I'll click the outlet here, turn on. It works. This outlet even tells you what volts it's at, what amps are coming out. 5 volts, 2 amps, charging 10 watts right now, this iPad. The next thing I'll test here is the DC outlet here. This thing has gone the mile. I'm gonna plug this in to the DC outlet here. Oh, I heard it. It's already charged because I charged it a little bit ago. It works. Let's test the inverter on-off switch. Although quite archaic, the switch is working as designed. So not bad, it stays there without me holding it, but I'm gonna have to attach this front still. Get this perfect. Now let's see. Okay, they're still working. So I'm getting around to the last connection here, which is connecting the AC to the inverter. Here we got the cable that goes up to the outlet, and I've split it to the three components. You got ground, negative, and positive. Positive goes to the brass screw on this. Negative goes to silver. Ground goes to green. So you just put them in there and screw in these things to get them tight. And then you'll close this up, plug that right into the inverter, and that basically extends the outlet up to there. Does it work?
Yep.
Hey, 509.
Nice work,
man. Heck yeah. Okay, I'll go finish it up. So since that worked, you go ahead and just close this up and screw it in here. And that's basically the last of the electrical. Got both outlets plugged in back here now. That's the remote inverter switch. And now just gonna clean up these cables, get them tucked up there with some clamps or something. And that's pretty much it. All right, so tired of being down here in the trunk in the dark. I think it's all done. So check out the finished product here. Cables are nice and out of the way, protected. You got the bats under there. I'm pretty sure it's protected by the Max Tracks when they hang here.
I know this stuff is. Can get the max tracks back on the wall, start packing to go.
Thanks for watching this video about redoing our electrical system. If you enjoyed this video, like and subscribe. And if you want to help us out some more, check out our Patreon. Make sure to stick around with us, because next time we are getting back on the road.